We are in for a treat this week as well, getting three launches for us within 24 hours. The launch window for the first launch starts tomorrow morning at 11:34, so we'll be watching close. Then tomorrow night, that much anticipated Starliner Boeing launch set to go off just after 10:30 at night. Then the third and final launch set for just after 11 next Tuesday morning.
And a major one that everyone is watching for is the CST-100 Starliner launch. The United Launch Alliance and Boeing have been trying to get a crewed mission in space for years now. And after much anticipation, it is just over 36 hours away from launching into space. Scott Heidler from our sister station in Orlando is showing us the final few things happening before this duo makes history.
Starliner one step closer to history. It made the slow roll at 1 mile an hour out to the launch pad, clicking into place for Monday's launch. Boeing spacecraft atop a United Launch Alliance Atlas V, standing 172 feet, rolled into position at Launch Complex 41 at the Cape Canaveral Space Force Station. Launch managers pulled go to proceed on Friday, the rocket and crew prepping all weekend for the crew test mission's Monday night launch.
The two phases of the mission that are the most challenging, at least in my mind, are the energetic things, right? The launch with a new launch vehicle, launching humans for the first time. Obviously, we've had good success with this Atlas V system in the past.
Once rolled into place, the crew access arm was put into position, now awaiting the two NASA test astronauts to take their positions, Commander Butch Wilmore and Sonny Williams. They'll dock at the International Space Station for about 8 days. In a great deal of that time, they'll be testing out the new Starliner. And once it returns different than SpaceX's Crew Dragon, it'll return to land, not water.
And touchdown Starliner.
The Boeing system, because we're landing on land, has airbags that inflate underneath the bottom of the capsule to help take care of that sudden stop at the bottom.
It'll be the first time ever that an Atlas V rocket will carry humans, and the first mission of NASA's Commercial Crew Program to launch from the Cape Canaveral Space Force Station. The much-delayed Starliner will join SpaceX's Crew Dragon on 6-month rotations up to the ISS. And once Starliner is certified, it'll provide an important second option up to the ISS from American soil.
And if you and the family want to make the drive over to our space coast tomorrow to view the launch, there are a bunch of places you can view the launch up close, including the Kennedy Space Center Visitor Complex.